वेलकम टू द 19th लेक्चर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड मैनेजमेंट. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव टॉक अबाउट जॉब कॉस्टिंग. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल टॉक अबाउट प्रोसेस कॉस्टिंग. सो व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन जॉब कॉस्टिंग एंड प्रोसेस कॉस्टिंग इज दैट जॉब कॉस्टिंग इज अप्लाइड टू अ पर्टिकुलर जॉब और अ पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल और पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट दैट इज बीइंग क्रिएटेड और दैट इज बीइंग प्रोड्यूस्ड. But process costing is applied to the product which is made into a continuous process. Like let's say there is one product which is made into processes, process 1, process 2, process 3. So in such a cases, process costing is applied. So what it says, process costing applies to continuous production system producing nearly identical units. For example, chemicals, oils, plastic, rubber, glass, mining, cement and food processing. In case of food processing, there are two processes. First is food cooking and second is food freezing. So these are two processes that comes under food product. So in such a cases, process costing is applied. Production takes place through a series of processes. So as we have told, production takes place into series of processes. There will be process 1, then after there will be process 2. Or processes may be in arranged in a series or series parallel. So in this case, two processes or two to three processes run in parallel, and then at the end that product will get assembled. Means product will be manufactured parallelly in number of processes, and at the end, after completing n number of processes, that product will get assembled. Costing requires many work in progress accounts, one for each process. So for every process there will be work in process amount. Now in case of job costing, there was job 1, job 2, job 3. For every job there was a work in progress account. But in case of this process costing, for not only for every job but also for every process, there will be work in progress account. As goods move from one process to another, work in process cost are transferred gradually. For example, let's say one product is made into three processes, process 1, process 2, process 3. After completing process 1, it will move to process 2, then it will move to process 3. So for process 1, there will be work in progress account. When process 1 will complete, that work in progress account will get transferred to process 2. When process 2 will finish, that work in progress account will get transferred to process 3. And when all the processes will get completed, the accounting for final product will be done. So this is what written in this particular slide. There is a direct material, direct labor for process 1, work in progress account. Now that work in progress account will get transferred to process 2. So the blue line shows flow of cost data. So work in progress account cost will get sent to process 2, and that will get sent to final product. And final product work in progress account will send to cost of good sales. So red line shows the flow of resources and blue line shows the flow of cost data. So this is a process costing or process in series. Number of processes are running. Let's take one example. Assume that there are only two processes in a continuous production system. First is cooking and second is freezing. So in this case, we are going to take example of food production. So first process is cooking and then freezing. Cost of cooking department are transferred to the freezing department. We have told already that cost of cooking department or cost of one process will get transferred to another process. Now in this case, cooking is one process and freezing is another process. Now cost driver is amount of cooked food per kg. Food into the kg. Cost driver unit will be accumulated cost in the cooking department. So total cost of cooking department divided by amount of food cooked into the kg. So that will be your cost driver unit. Accumulated cost in the cooking department divided by kilogram of cooked cooked food. Amount transferred to the freezing department will be total cost driver, right, into kg. So cost driver unit, so that cost driver unit amount will get transferred to the freezing department, and that is what kg of cooked food physically transferred to the freezing department. So amount transferred to the freezing department will be your cost driver unit into the amount of food cooked and transferred to the freezing department. Now work in progress account for cooking department, as we are using T accounts, so work in progress for cooking department is, so direct material cost is 14, direct labor is 4, and fixed cost overhead is 8. So total it will become 14 plus 4 plus 8, that is 26. So 26 amount of food, or the amount of food of which cost is 26 is made, but out of which only 24 is get transferred cost of goods completed to a freezing department. So though the amount is produced 26, but transferred to freezing department is only 24. So your ending inventory will be 26 minus 24, that is 2. So on debit side, it will be direct material cost 14 plus direct labor cost 4 plus overhead 8, that will be 26. Of worth rupees 26, food is created, but out of which worth rupees 24, it is transferred to the freezing department. So that is get credited. Now in case of freezing work in progress, it will be the amount of worth rupees 24 food is transferred from the cooking department. So it will be debited on the freezing side. So 24. In case of freezing department, direct labor is 1 and overhead cost is 2. So that will be 27, total in 27. Out of which worth rupees 25, finished goods are completed. So only transferred cost of goods completed to finished goods is 25. So your ending inventory will be 2. So 25 will be returned on credit side, and the 24 direct labor cost and overhead are written on debit side. So this is how it is written. Now this is the this is written in T accounts. How it is written, how these entries are made in journal. So work in progress cooking is 14 and direct material inventory is 14. So it is on debit side and it is on credit side. Work in progress for cooking is 4, that is direct labor, and 4 accrual payroll, that is 4 is used, which is written on credit side. Again work in progress cooking is 8 and 4 fixed overhead is written 8 on credit side. So on freezing side, 24 worth rupees amount food is taken, right? So on cooking side it is credited, and on freezing side it is debited. Again so likewise we are making entries for each and everything whichever is written in this particular table. Now let's take one more example. A toy manufacturer company produces only one type of toy. The toy is processed in two departments. So there is one toy manufacturer company which is producing only one type of toy, and there are two departments which are working on it. So first is forming department and second is finishing department. So in April work started. So before April there was they haven't done any work, and in April starting they have started to do some work. So in April work started for 25,000 toys in a forming department, but only 20,000 units were completed in April. So they have decided to make 25,000 toys, but they can only able to make 20,000 units in April. Now the target was 25,000, but they have made 20,000. So there were 5,000 toys that they have to complete yet. Now only 25% processing was done on the remaining 5,000 units. Now 20,000 units are totally completed, and remaining 5,000 units they have started to work, and they have done 25,000 processing work on that 5,000 units. Means 5,000 units are processed 25%. That is, this 5000 units received only 25% of conversion resources. Means 5000 units they are supposed to complete, but they have only completed 25% of the 5000. Means they have used 25% resources to make 5000 units. Now, how should the farming department calculate the cost of goods transferred and the cost of goods remaining as a work in process? So let's see how to solve it. Now, farming department cost in April are as follows. So this is some data they have given. So direct material cost is 70,000 rupees. Conversion cost means what? So direct material cost is 70,000 rupees, which is used for all 25,000 units. But conversion cost is not used for all 25,000 units. Conversion cost is used totally only for 20,000 units because they have completed. And 25% of conversion cost is applied to 5,000 units, which is remaining. So conversion cost are direct labor cost, which is 10,625. Fixed overhead is 31,875. So total conversion cost is 10,625 plus 31,875, which is in total 42,500. Now cost to account for means what? Total direct material cost plus conversion cost. So it will be 70,000 plus 42,500, which is equal to 1,12,500. So total cost is 1,12,500. Now there are 5 steps to solve this problem. First is summarize the flow of physical units. Second is calculate in terms of equivalent units. So this is meaning, the meaning of equivalent unit is that the total number of product completed, that is 20,000, plus the cost which is applied to 5,000 units which are remaining or which are in process. Three is summarize the total cost to account for. 4 is calculate unit cost. 5 is apply cost to unit completed and to units in the ending work in process. So equivalent units are the number of completed units that could have been produced from the inputs applied. So let's see. Step 1 is summarize the flow of physical units. So number of completed number of toys are 20,000 units. Partially completed are 5,000 units. That is, 25% of conversion cost is applied to 5,000 units. Means 75% work is still remaining. Now calculate the output in terms of equivalent units. So equivalent number of units completed are 20,000, which are totally completed, plus 5,000 units are completed, but only 25%. So 25% of 5,000. So that will be 1,250. So total number of units completed are 20,000, which are totally completed, plus 25% of 5,000, so that is 1,250, which is equal to 21,250 units. So these are equivalent units that are made. Now there is a note, direct material was received by all the 25,000 units, right? 25,000 units are using direct material, but conversion resources were received by only 21,250 equivalent units, because only 25% of the 25% is done for 5,000 units. So this is what. Now how to make accounting? So farming department month ended April 30. So we have seen 2 steps, step 1, step 2. Now let's talk about step 3, step 4 and step 5. Step 3 and 4 are short, but step 5 is a little long. So step 3 is cost to account for rupees. So total cost is 1,12,500 that we have seen. Total cost is 1,12,500. Direct material cost is 70,000 and conversion cost is 42,500, that is 10,625 plus 31,875. So that is what written here. So total cost is 1,12,500, direct material cost is 70,000, conversion cost is 42,500. Now unit cost, how to calculate unit cost? For total cost, the total number of units are 25,000. So total cost divided by total number of units, दैट इज 1,12,5,500 डिवाइडेड बाई 25,000 विच इज इक्वल टू 4.80 रुपीज. टोटल कॉस्ट फॉर डिरेक्ट मटेरियल, सो टोटल कॉस्ट इज डिरेक्ट, टोटल कॉस्ट फॉर डिरेक्ट मटेरियल इज 70,000 एंड डिरेक्ट मटेरियल इज यूज फॉर ऑल 25,000 यूनिट्स. सो 70,000 डिवाइडेड बाई नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स दैट इज 25,000 दैट विल गिव यू 2.80 रुपीज. कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट, नाउ कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट इज अप्लाइड फॉर 21,500 यूनिट्स. वी हैव सीन हियर दैट इक्वेलेंट यूनिट्स आर 21,250. सो कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट इज अप्लाइड ओनली टू 21,250 यूनिट्स. सो कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट इज 42,500 डिवाइडेड बाय 21,500. सो दैट विल बी 2.00 रुपीज. सो दिस इज हाउ यूनिट कॉस्ट इज कैलकुलेटेड, दैट इज स्टेप फोर. नाउ स्टेप फाइव. सो स्टेप फाइव इज एप्लीकेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट टू यूनिट्स कंप्लीटेड एंड ट्रांसफर टू फाइनल डिपार्टमेंट. सो 20,000 यूनिट्स एट द रेट ऑफ 480. सो फाइनल फाइनल नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स आर कंप्लीटेड आर 20,000 यूनिट्स. सो इन टू यूनिट पर यूनिट कॉस्ट इज 480. सो दैट विल बी 20,000 इन टू 480, दैट इज फाइनल कॉस्ट विच इज ट्रांसफर टू फाइनल डिपार्टमेंट. सो दैट विल बी 96,000, राइट. फॉर डिरेक्ट मटेरियल ऑल्सो इट विल बी 25,000 माइनस 20,000, दैट इज 5,000. सो 5,000 आर रिमेनिंग. सो इन टू 2.80, सो दैट विल बी 14,000. एंड अगेन कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट इज 5,000, दैट इज रिमेनिंग यूनिट्स इन टू 0.25 इक्वल्स टू 1,250 एट यूनिट एट. सो द यूनिट प्राइज इज, सो 1,250 इन टू 2, राइट. सो योर टोटल कॉस्ट विल बिकम 1,12,500 एंड यूर. सो दिस इज टोटल कॉस्ट अकाउंटेड इज 1,12,500 एंड टोटल कॉस्ट इज गिवन दैट इज 1,12,500. सो दिस इज हाउ वी हैव मेड द अकाउंटिंग ऑफ टोटल कॉस्ट, राइट. आई होप दिस स्लाइड इज क्लियर टू यू. नेक्स्ट. सो दिस इज हाउ जनरल एंट्रीज आर मेड. वर्क इन प्रोसेस फॉर्मिंग डिपार्टमेंट 70,000 that will get credited into direct material inventory. Work in process of forming department is 10,625 that will get transferred to direct labor forming credit side 10,625, and this is how the journal entries are made. Now work in process forming department will be direct material is 70,000, direct labor is 10,625, total fixed overhead is 31,875. So that is get transferred to credit side to finishing department, that is 96,000. And cost to account for is 1,12,500. So minus 96,000. So balance at the end of April is 16,500. Now consider the production of forming department in May. So in May, the company had a May beginning inventory. It is not inventory, it is work in process. So wherever there is an inventory, write work in process. So the company had a May beginning inventory of, sorry, work in process of 5,000 units. As you know, the 5,000 units were work in process. They were remaining. 20,000 were completed and 5,000 were remaining. Now it started production of 26,000 items. This is a new information. They have started production of 26,000 items. So in total 31,000 items they have to made. It could complete production and transfer of 24,000 items to the finishing department. So at the end of May, they have to made 31,000 units, but they could complete only 24,000 items, and they have transferred it to finishing department. The remaining 7,000 items could receive only 60% of the conversion cost. Now remaining in last example, the 5,000 units were receiving only 25% of conversion cost. In this case, the 7,000 items could receive only 60% of the conversion cost. How should the forming department calculate the cost of goods transferred and the cost of goods remaining as a VIP? So transferred are 24,000 and remaining are 7,000. So how they could calculate the cost? Effect of beginning inventory. So now consider the production of forming. The company had a May beginning inventory of 5,000 units, right? Summarizes the first step is summarizes the flow of physical units. So total was 24,000, completed 24,000 units, partially completed 7,000 units. So 7,000 units have received 60% conversion resources. So 7,000 will be, that is 5,000 that which were present at the beginning of May, plus 26,000 that they have decided to complete at the end of May, minus 24,000 that is they have completed, so that is 7,000. Second step is calculate the output in terms of equivalent units, right? So 24,000 units are wholly completed, plus 7,000, actually it's not 6,000, 7,000 into 0.60, that is 60% of 7,000. That is 7,000 units are partially completed and they have used 60% of conversion resources. So your equivalent units are 28,200 units. So note again, direct material was received by, direct material is used by all 31,000 units, but conversion resources are used by only 28,200 units. Now in May, the following costs were incurred by forming department. So the direct material cost is given 82,100. Conversion cost is direct labor 14,560. Overhead is 42,160. So that is total 14,560 plus 42,160 will be 56,720. And the total cost will be 82,100 plus 56,720, which will be 1,38,820 rupees. Now cost to account for can be calculated as follows. May initial inventory in the forming department is 16,500 and May manufacturing cost is, that is given 1,38,820. So cost, so total cost is 1,55,320, for which we have to calculate cost to account for. Now, inventory in the forming department consists of items produced in April and items produced in May. The unit cost of manufacturer of items made in April are different from those in May, obviously. How to account? So, the problem is that how to account for a VIP then? There are two methods. First is weighted average method and second is first in, first out method, that is FIFO method. Now, weighted average method. Unit cost are calculated as follows. So April end inventory rupees 14,000, that is given. May direct material cost is 82,000 divided by 18 April end inventory units are 5,000 plus May direct material, that is 26,000. So for direct material it will be 3.10 rupees per unit, and for conversion it will be cost in April plus cost in May, that is 2500 plus 56,720 divided by equivalent units for conversion in May. So equivalent units for conversion in May that we have calculated 28,200. So the cost is 2.10 rupees per unit. Now while looking at all these figures, we have to refer previous slides so that you will understand each and every figure or each and every value we have calculated or we have discussed. Now forming departments month ended April. So we have talked about step 1 and step 2 in this slide. Now we will talk about step 3, 4 and 5. So work in process April cost added in work in process April cost. So that will be 16,500 is total cost. Direct material cost is 14,000 and conversion cost is 2,500. Cost added in May. So these are the costs that are of April month that we have seen in last example. Cost added in May. So cost added in May is 1,28,820. That is total cost we have calculated. डायरेक्ट मटेरियल कॉस्ट इज 82,100 एंड कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट इज 56,700. सो फॉर ईच एंड एवरी थिंग यू हैव टू रेफर अ लास्ट स्लाइड्स सो दैट यू विल गेट क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ इट. कॉस्ट टू अकाउंट फॉर, टोटल कॉस्ट इज 1,55,320 एंड सो दैट इज 16,000 प्लस 1,28,000 एंड इन केस ऑफ डायरेक्ट मटेरियल इट इज 96,100 फॉर कन्वर्जन इट इज 59,200 दैट इज टोटल ऑफ कॉस्ट इन अप्रैल प्लस कॉस्ट इन मे. नाउ इक्विवेलेंट यूनिट कॉस्ट रुपीज आर 5.20 राइट. एज यू नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट यूनिट कॉस्ट, द टोटल कॉस्ट डिवाइडेड बाई नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स मैन्युफैक्चर्ड. फॉर डायरेक्ट मटेरियल इट इज 3.10 एंड फॉर कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट इट इज 2.10 रुपीज पर यूनिट. सो दिस विल बी कैलकुलेटेड एज टोटल कॉस्ट डिवाइडेड बाई नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स मैन्युफैक्चर्ड. नाउ स्टेप फोर, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट टू यूनिट कंप्लीटेड एंड ट्रांसफर टू फाइनल डिपार्टमेंट. सो 24,000 यूनिट्स आर मैन्युफैक्चर्ड एंड ट्रांसफर्ड. सो एट यूनिट प्राइस 5.20, सो 5.20 इंटू 24,000 दैट विल बी 1,24,800 राइट. नाउ फॉर डायरेक्ट मटेरियल 7,000 यूनिट्स आर रिमेनिंग राइट. सो 7,000 इंटू 3.10 सो दैट विल बी रिटर्न 21,700 एंड फॉर कन्वर्जन कॉस्ट 4,200 इंटू 2.10 इट विल बी 8,820 राइट. सो ओवरहेड कॉस्ट, सो द टोटल कॉस्ट विल बी, टोटल वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस कॉस्ट विल बी 30,520 एंड द ओवरऑल कॉस्ट इफ यू कैलकुलेट 1,24,800 प्लस 30,520 दैट विल बी 1,55,320. सो दैट इज वॉट टोटल कॉस्ट इज वी हैव अकाउंटेड. नाउ सेकेंड मेथड इज फर्स्ट इन फर्स्ट आउट मेथड. सो इट डिस्टिंग्विशेस द करंट वर्क डन फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस वर्क डन ऑन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ इन्वेंट्री ऑफ वर्क इन प्रोसेस. द इक्विवेलेंट यूनिट इज कैलकुलेटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वर्क डन इन द करंट पीरियड. सो द इक्विवेलेंट यूनिट्स आर कैलकुलेटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वर्क डन इन द करंट पीरियड. सो दैट इज इक्विवेलेंट यूनिट्स आर फॉर डायरेक्ट मटेरियल 31,000 माइनस 5,000 दैट इज 31,000 टोटल दैट इज 5,000 प्लस 26,000 दैट इज 31,000 माइनस 5,000 दैट इज 26,000 यूनिट्स दैट दे हैव टू मेड. एंड फॉर कन्वर्जन 28,200 माइनस 1,250 दैट इज 26,950 यूनिट्स. इट इन्वॉल्व्स मोर कंपटीशन कंपेयर टू वेटेड एवरेज मेथड दैट इज व्हाई इट इज ऑलमोस्ट नेवर यूज्ड इन प्रैक्टिस. एज कंपेयर टू वेटेड एवरेज मेथड इट रिक्वायर्स मोर कंपटीशन सो इट इज ऑलमोस्ट नेवर यूज्ड इन प्रैक्टिस. सो वेटेड एवरेज मेथड इज इन दिस केस यूनिट कॉस्ट आर कैलकुलेटेड एज फॉलोज. सो वी हैव सीन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड इट इज रिपीटेड. सो फॉर टुडे वी विल स्टॉप हियर. थैंक यू सो मच.